Jesus than us to trust and obey in the Lord. Amen. And indeed, where he sent us, we shall go, for we'll have no fear. We'll know that we are walking with the Lord. So all we have to do is to trust and obey. I don't think that the mic is on. Thank you. Good morning and welcome to today's service.
Good morning.
Today we are celebrating the birthdays of two people, Ziana Pereira and Molefe Mholoboto. Are they here with us today? I know Ziana, she's in Mpumalanga. If Molefe Mholoboto with us, maybe she's still coming. And is there any other, are there any other people who are celebrating their birthdays today? Don't be shy to raise up your hand if you're listening. All right. And there is no wedding anniversary this week. All right. We continue to ask that whenever you pray, you uphold the following people in your prayers. And those are Chris and Shelley Ferguson, Lydia Maliti, Esther Homu, Evan Hedges, Dorcas Madikoto, and I went and see her on Friday. She said, I should say thank you for praying for her. Anashivambu, as she continued to recover. Renzin Matato, Rebecca Shika, Siflaro Ramohale, and Franz Sitsapelo. May we always continue to keep them in our prayers whenever we pray. Let us pray. Lord God, we thank you that indeed if we put our trust in you, we will worthless, but our cups will be filled with joy as we walk with you, Lord, at all times. Walk with us, Lord, even this morning, as we gather here, Lord, to worship you. Walk with AMF, Lord, this morning, as we'll be meeting a Lord to choose their leadership of this year. Walk with all those, Lord, whom they've asked us to keep them in our prayers. And Lord, deliver them according to their needs. Walk with those, Lord, who are celebrating their birthdays this week. And continue to shower them, Lord, with your everlasting blessings. We ask all this, Lord, through Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Our service continues on page 104. My dear sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Honor your father and mother.
Amen.
You shall not steal.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
You shall not give false evidence.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
You shall not covet the position of others.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
The saying is sure and worthy of full acceptance that Jesus Christ came to the world to save sinners. Let us confess our sin, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with our neighbors. Almighty God,
our Heavenly Father, in penitence we confess that we have sinned against you through our own faults, in thoughts, words, and deeds, and in what we have left undone, for the sake of your Son, Christ our Lord. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name.
And the Almighty God, who forgave all who truly repent, have mercy on you, pardon your sins and set you free from them, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We join together as we pray the collect of this week. Gracious Father,
among us or not. Yeah, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to
psalm is Psalm 95. I will start with the first verse and congregation before we can comment. Oh, come, let us sing out to the Lord. Let us shout in triumph to the rock of our salvation.
Let us come before his face.
And a great king above all gods.
He stands at the depths of the earth, and the peaks of the mountains are his source.
The sea is his, and he made it. His hands molded dry land.
Come, let us worship and bow down, and kneel before the Lord our Maker.
For he is our Lord. We are his people, and the shepherds.
Today, if only you would hear his voice, do not harden your hearts as you remember, as on that day of Massah in the wilderness.
When your fathers tested me, put me to proof through the hands, see my works.
40 years long I know. Yeah.
his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there, and Jesus, tired as he was coming from a journey, sat down by the well. It was about noon. When a Samaritan woman came to draw water, Jesus said to her, "Will you give me a drink?" His disciples had gone into town to buy food. The Samaritan woman said to him, "You are a Jew, and I am a Samaritan woman. How can you ask me for a drink?" For the Jews did not associate with the Samaritans. Jesus answered her, "If you knew the gift of God, and it is that I ask you a drink, you would not have asked me, and he would have given you the living water." The woman said, "You have nothing to draw with, and the well is too deep. Where can you get this living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us this well and drank from it himself, as did also his sons and his livestock?" Jesus answered, "Everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again. But whoever drinks the water that I give will never be thirsty. Indeed, the water I give them will become in a spring of water welling up to eternal life." The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water so that I won't get thirsty and have to keep coming here to draw water." He told her, "Go call your husband and come back." "I have no husband," she replied. Jesus said to her, "You are right when you say you have no husband. The fact is, you have had 5 husbands, and the man you have now is not your husband. What you have just had is quite true." Woman said, "I can see that you are a prophet. Our ancestors worshipped on this mountain, but you Jews claim that the place where we must worship is in Jerusalem." "Woman," Jesus replied, "believe me, a time is coming when you will worship the Father neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem. You Samaritans worship what you do not know. We worship what we do know, for salvation is from the Jews. Yet a time is coming, and has now come, when the true worshippers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For they are the kind of worshippers the Father seeks. God is spirit, and his worshippers must be in spirit and in truth." The woman said, "I know that Messiah called Christ is coming. When he comes, he will explain everything to us." Then Jesus said, "I am the one speaking to you. I am he." This is the gospel of Christ.
in truth and in spirit, for you are in truth and spirit. Father God, this is your time, this is your hour. Speak to us, Heavenly Father. Open our spiritual hearts, open our spiritual minds and ears to hear what your word is saying to us. Take the lips of your servant. Let it not be him who speaks, but it be you who interpret your word to the people. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be accepted in your sight, O my God and my Redeemer. Amen. You may be seated. I greet you all in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Our message for today comes from the Gospel reading of John chapter 4, reading from verse 5 to 26. And the theme of the message is the gift from the Lord. When you're talking about a gift, according to Google, says it's a token of appreciation for something or for a gesture that someone has done. If someone has passed a school, their parents give them a token of appreciation, which is a gift. If it's your birthday, they will give you a gift. But today, in our reading, we see Jesus Christ offering a gift without a special occasion. It was not Valentine's Day. The Bible that I'm reading says it was not even an anniversary. It was just a normal day like this Sunday of the 12th today. It was just a normal day, and Jesus Christ saw it fitting that he gives away the gift of life. When I was growing up at Sunday school, the teachers, they only taught us that the Samaritan woman didn't want to give Jesus a drink without explaining why. So I grew up thinking that maybe the Samaritan woman thought she was important than Jesus. Maybe she thought if Jesus Christ drank this water, maybe the town won't have enough water next time. But today, let us unpack why, the real reason why the Samaritan woman didn't want to give Jesus the water. After Jesus Christ realized that there is a competition between him and the Pharisees, he decided to leave Jerusalem and go to Galilee. But one thing about GPS is that it will take you where you don't want to go. It will keep on saying turn left, even when you know the route. So Jesus' GPS said, you must pass through the town of Samaria. And based on the book of 2 Kings chapter 17 on verse 24, if you read it, it says, after God realized that the Israelites were sinning, he decided to take the Jews out of Samaria and put them somewhere. So he brought in the people, the new people. And now the Jews saw that these people are trying to replace us in the face of God. So there started to be a friction between the Samaritans and the Jews. And the Jews called the Samaritans the unholy people because they were mixed race. They were both the Jews and they were both kids from the Jews and the Samaritans. But today, Christ doesn't care about the race. Christ enters the town of Samaria not caring that whether you are a black person or you are a white person, whether you are a Jew or a Samaritan. The Bible says Jesus Christ's human nature kicked in and he started to feel the thirst. And when he entered the town of Samaria, he saw a well of Jacob. If you read the book of Genesis, you'll start to understand why they call it the well of Jacob. It's because Jacob bought a land and built this well for his sons and for his livestock. So the people continue to call it the well of Jacob. So Jesus Christ saw it fitting that he find water. In the side of Jesus Christ, family of God, there's no, what do we call it? There's no thing that we call it, unforeseen circumstances. The things just don't happen. There's a reason why Jesus Christ stopped there. He saw it fitting. He could have went to a shop. If you read the Bible, it says he sent his disciples to go and buy food. He could have said to them, bring water also. But he saw it fitting that he sit on this well, and something miraculous has happened. The Bible says a woman came, and this woman was there to draw water from this well. Jesus Christ said to the woman, can you just please give me a cup? Maybe fella, I know what, even if a teaspoon, just to quench my thirst. I like the response of this woman, because in the world that we are living today, we are bound by the rules. We are bound by the law. People who grew up in the time of apartheid, they will know that you don't just talk to anyone. There are rules. You don't just go to any bathroom. There are rules. So the Samaritan woman said to Jesus Christ, whom are you? What kind of a person are you when you are a Jew and you come to talk to a Samaritan? And Jesus Christ, the conversation between Jesus Christ and the people was so funny, because Jesus Christ never answered their questions. He made them to think out of the box. The woman said, what type of a person are you when you are a Jew and you start to talk to a Samaritan? Jesus Christ said, if you knew who I was, you wouldn't be asking this question. The problem, we think we know Jesus Christ, family of God. The problem, we think we know who he is and how he does his things. But today, Jesus Christ is saying to the Samaritan woman, you don't know who I am, because you wouldn't waste your energy asking me these questions. And he continued by saying, the ones who drink vanakwa, the ones who drink maybe macro water, the ones who continue to drink this aqualifa will get thirsty again. But the gift that I'm giving you, family of God, is the living water. The theme for Lent for Christ Church, it says, let us meet under the tree of life. Maybe Muruti, people don't understand that for a tree to survive, it needs the living water. For a tree to survive, maybe we can meet under the tree of life. After 2 days, the tree starts to walk out. The tree starts to die, because there's no living water. Jesus Christ is saying, I offer something that no one can offer you. This gift that I'm giving to you, you can go around this town of Samaria, you will never find it. The second question that the lady asked is that, do you think you are better than our father Jacob when a young man? Because I think at that time Jesus Christ was just starting his ministry. So maybe his height was just like mine. And they look at him and say, this one is a dream. Jesus Christ said, the problem with you is that you don't know who I am. You start to compare me with the things of this world. You start to compare me with the people of this world. When situations come our way, we start to compare the glory of God with what is happening around us. We forget the gift that is trying to give us. Our situations are starting to cloud our judgment. Our situations, they are starting to cloud how we see God in our lives. Jesus Christ is saying, the problem is that you don't know who I am and what I'm bringing into your life. Maybe the woman went to an extent of asking Jesus Christ, I can see that you're talking, man of God. What type of this water are you talking about? Because we have tasted all the water that is there here in Samaria. If it was here in Polokwane, we would have said, we have tested every brand that they is in the shops, but we have never found this water that you're talking about. And the problem is that you who say you're talking about this water, you are also thirsty. You are selling me something you don't even have. That's our human limitations. People, when they start to have these minds, they think God is limited by the situations. Family of God, the Lord is giving us the water as the gift of life. What we need to do as we embark in this journey of the Lent season under the tree of life, we just need to ask Him and say, God, can you please just give us this water? For in this world, there are so many fires that are trying to break us. There are so many fires that are trying to burn us. Can you just please give us and be like the rich man who went to hell and said, I wish someone can tell my brothers and my family about the place that I am at now. When we wake up every day, it seems like it's efficient to see that there's a car accident somewhere. It seems like it's efficient when we see that someone has killed someone. It seems like efficient. We no longer, there's a cool way they say, everyone in this world is trying to win. So people no longer care when they lose you. People are no longer crying. We cry today and then tomorrow we continue with our lives. It is because we don't have this living water inside of us. We need this living water so that all the evil things, when they try to burn us, we know that we are standing with God under the tree of life. So, family of God, as I draw to conclusion, I just want to state that after the conversation between the Samaritan woman and Jesus Christ, she went back and told the people about the good things that Christ has told him, about the gift that Christ has given her. She went and told other people, and people started to believe. And people, the Bible says, people started to have a change of mind. People started to believe in the good news. Once you receive this living water, people will come to you and say, God, we know that you are a drunkard. What has happened to your life? We know that you were sinking in debt. We know that maybe your marriage was crumbling. We know maybe that you were going in and out of hospitals because of the sicknesses. What has happened? And you will tell them that I have received the living water. For Jesus Christ is saying, the water that I'm giving you to you is going to serve you until the eternal life. The water that I'm giving you to you is not the water of this world. I'm giving it to you so that you might be saved in the eternal life. There's a very song that I love, which says,
Mudau.
invitation to this well of life. Whether you are a sinner, whether you think you are a good person, whether you pray seven times a day, whether you think you are giving more offering than the others, we are being called. There's a water that we are being called to come to drink. So, family of God, whether you are a Jew, whether you are a Samaritan, whether you come from Malaysia, you come from far, 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 like a few days, far, in another country, in Canada. Jesus Christ doesn't care where you come from. The invitation has been granted. Let us come for the living water. God bless you. Amen.
Something that I've done for a very long time.
Today I lay it at the altar. When I come back, I will be speaking about the testimony of how you have delivered me. Maybe even today you are still blaming somebody for the death of a particular person in your family. Even today you have not found closure. You have not accepted this death. You still blame other people. You still feel there was another hand involved. Today, late at the altar, because this water, this spring, cannot well up inside of you to eternal life when you hold on to such things. Father, in the mighty, wonderful name of Jesus, the name above all names, Holy Spirit, we come before you, we humble ourselves, we lay it all at the altar. Father, we thank you for the powerful word. Lord, your word is powerful and mighty. It is filled with anointing. When your word is spoken, my Lord, power and anointing is released. Father, I am bringing before you all those that are saying, I have carried this burden of shame, of pain, of guilt for so many years. But today, I come before you, Lord. I lay it at the altar. Lord, we thank you because today you are asking us, Hori, do you even know who I am? Do you know what I can do for you? We thank you, Lord, that today, right now, you are delivering us from all these things that we have carried inside of us, the pain, the burden, the guilt, the shame. It has made us not to be able to receive the water that is supposed to spring and well up us into eternal life. Father, we come against the plans of the evil one. We come against the plans of the evil one, against families, my Father. We are coming against the plans of the evil one, my Father, against the church. We remove the evil veil that covers the nations, the evil veil that covers the families, the evil veil that covers the young children, my Father, and makes them, my Lord, to be scattered in the streets instead of running after the weight and running after the kingdom. Lord, we release your power and your anointing right now. Father, meet our needs and our wants right now. That, Lord Jesus, we will not go out of this place the same way that we came when we came in the morning. Father, we consecrate ourselves. We soak our garments, my God, in the blood of Jesus. My God, the Bible tells us that you are wrapped in light, my Father, like a garment, my Father. The Bible tells us that your word is so powerful, right at your command. The waters sitting on top of the mountains come gushing down. My God, the Bible tells us in the book of Hebrews chapter 1 verse 7, that my God, you make angels the spirit, but we who are your servants, you make us the flames of fire. My God, we are asking you that when we leave this place today, our language will change, my Father. We begin to speak things, my Lord, that the eye does not see, because we don't walk in our understanding, my God. But Father, we are leaning completely in you. We are walking in faith. We are telling our circumstances today that our God is bigger than the circumstances. Father, in the mighty, wonderful name of Jesus, we command the angels of heaven to come today and change our destiny for the better. My God, we've been coming here Sunday in, Sunday out, but for many days, my Lord, we didn't receive your word. We repent today. We are going to receive your word. We are going to stand on your word, even when the circumstances before us don't match what we are saying. We will continue to say it. In the book of Psalms 45 verse 1, the Bible says, my tongue is like a pen in the hand of a skillful writer. Help us, Lord Jesus, that we begin to speak life into our situations. Help us, my God, that we begin to see life where there's no life. Hallelujah, my God, take us into that valley of dry bones, my Father, where we see the dry bones, my Lord, and the dry bones, they begin to move and they begin to connect, and the tissues are brought back together. Yes, Lord, we are Christians, but for many times we speak negative things, my Lord, and what we don't understand is that the accuser of brethren, the accuser of brethren is behind the words that we have spoken. Today we are suffering, some of us, because we think we are being bewitched, but we have bewitched ourselves with the words that we speak. Because when we receive Jesus Christ, the words that we speak, they must change, because whatever that we speak becomes legislation. Because we are the children of God, we belong in the kingdom of God, we are the heirs of the heaven, of the kingdom of heaven. Our words, they become legislation. But Lord, today we repent that many times we spoke negatively. I know that some families, they don't look forward to seeing us, because when we come, we speak negative things, yet we come to church and we do all the things that are supposed to be done in church. Father, I pray in the mighty living name of Jesus Christ that, Lord, today we don't go back the same way that we came in here. That, Father, we will be filled with the power. We will be filled with your anointing that breaks every yoke. Hallelujah, my Father. I am praying that today will be a day that will be nothing like nothing we expected, because you are a God that gives us things exceedingly abundantly, far more than we can imagine. My God, the book of Corinthians says, Lord, the things that you have in store for us, no eye has seen it, no mind can conceive it, no ear has heard, because the things that you have in store for us, my God, are so great. Yet we walk like failures, yet we speak like witches, my God. Hallelujah. Father, we come against this evil veil that is covering the Christians, that is making Christians to speak this language of poverty. Christians who walk like losers. Father, today we are claiming the victory. Lord, in the mighty, wonderful name of Jesus, we are saying, Father, we open our hearts, release your power. Then we walk out of here, my God, not because things will change immediately, but because we believe that great is He that is in us than the one that is in the world. Hallelujah, my Father, when we walk out of here, my God, today, Lord, we thank you that you're meeting our needs. Hallelujah, we know, Father, that above everything else, my God, the most important thing is that you are still seated at the throne. We may be experiencing deaths in our family, we may be experiencing challenges at work, but Lord, help us to look up in heaven, that when the flesh is suffering, we will not look on the sides, but we will look up, my Father. And when we look up, there's a promise, the heavens will open. Hallelujah, my God, we believe today that the heavens are opening right now for us. Heavens are opening for our situations. Heaven are opening, my Lord. They are dealing with each and every situation that has been laid at the altar today. I challenge you not to be scared. Leave it at the altar. Maybe you identify with your pain so much that you don't know what will you do when you let go of your pain. But I want to tell you today, lay it at the altar. Lay it at the altar. Obedience is better than sacrifice. Lay it at the altar. The Lord is here to
meet our needs. He has spoken, and his word cannot be matched. He is great in heaven and on earth. He is Jehovah Jireh. Our needs he meets. There is nothing that surprises God about your situation. While the only thing that you must do is look up in heaven and see the heavens opening and see the angels coming down, just like Stephen did. In the mighty, wonderful name of Jesus, Lord, we pray, we thank you, we bless your name, for you are clothed in majesty. You cannot be compared to anyone on earth and in heaven. And we thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen.
Oh.
1:1 says, which is the prayer of getting over the gift unto the Lord, and the prayer of thanksgiving for the gift of the Lord.
Renew us by your spirit
and in him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, all who stand before you in heaven and earth, we worship you, Father Almighty, and Sons of everlasting praise, and together we say, blessed be the honor and glory and power, be yours forever and ever. Amen. As Christ has taught us, we are bold to sing the Lord's Prayer. We are bold to pray the Lord's Prayer.
Good morning, church. As the Sunday school today, have prepared a verse. John 3, chapter 4, verse 7. And it says, a Samaritan woman came in to draw some water, and Jesus said to her,
to lose you to interpret his words. And our dear sister will be able to
Yeah. Thank you.